John called this small, sketchy sculpture group The Temptation of Lot, about Lot and his daughters. John was fascinated by the biblical story, and this little grouping has more negative space. They are all touching each other, so you cannot separate them. It is one sculpture, three little figures. But it has more open spaces, and it has lots to see as you walk around. You get the fun of the dance of it. Dance being how it tells your eyes where to move. The arms make a dance, and the legs hold it stable. Lot, The Temptation of Lot. I don't remember whether he used models for this. Possibly he just had some fun doing it straight out of his imagination. He certainly had experience with life drawing and life sculpting from models, enough so that he understood anatomy and proportions. And here again, it's about balance and structure, and you can think of it totally in the abstract for a while to get the dynamic movement. And also, probably keep your sense of humor. It's good to approach this two-figure sculpture to where we see the relationship both emotionally and visually, abstractly. The two bodies have a wonderful wave motion that they share. They share a wave motion, and they're connected in that wave motion. We see a man very focused on a woman. The question is, where is her focus? His whole body is related to her. He's got a very slight spinal twist turning toward her, and he's got a hand on her shoulder. I'll let the viewer decide whether it's tenderly, strongly, or what that is. And then we say, where is her focus? Where is her body turned? Where is her mind turned? Where are her hands turned? I see a dance of three hands now. And as I walk around this sculpture, I am in a position now where I can see all four hands. They definitely make a pattern of their own that's very strong. Her hand and his hand are pointing toward each other. The upper hands are pointing toward each other, and the lower hands are actually facing each other. So you might say, in a sense, their bodies are related to each other in ways that you can see, then in ways that you might imagine other things go on between them. That's for the individual viewer to decide on his self or her own self. Of course, since her head is turned down and her face is somewhat hidden, there is the inclination to stoop down and look up into her face and see a rather solemn expression. This is over life size. When it's outdoors, you experience it as life size until you come right up to it. When you come right up to it, you can see and feel that it is over life size. I find there is a lot of emotion expressed through the forms of the sculpture. And somehow John, for me, has made very expressive backs in his work to experience. The legs are a beautiful rhythm of all four legs, and the arms with the elbows, again, So many hours go into the creation of this work that the artist has time to feel and experience and be conscious of all the different resonations that he makes. And then you can decide what you feel the mood is of this work. I'm purposely not giving you the name of it at this time because I would like each one of you to create your own title for this piece. Here we have again the totally universal theme, since every one of us did come from some woman's body, I think, of motherhood, childhood. Again, John gives us the rhythm of hands, parallel hands. We have the young boy child whose body knows very well how to cling strongly to its mother's body. And walking around to the back of this sculpture is full of gifts, because there's his other leg clinging to her body as she clings very strongly to his leg to hold him from falling. And he clings to her shoulder as well. So like all of these works of figures, there is that element of balance. How do you get a work to stand up and not fall over? It's an abstract concept of balance, an abstract challenge of balance. Here he's used a stool as a prop to the leg, and walking around this is very rewarding. And it brings up the questions of where is she looking and where is the babe looking? He's looking sort of in her direction and she's looking sort of in his direction, but neither one of them is looking at the other. Each one of them is looking out into his and her world, but their bodies are connected. I find a lot of joy in the love that John had for all the subtle forms and undulations of a person's body, and the enigmatic outward yet inward expression that each figure has. Here I come upon a wonderful tangle of legs, and then arms and hands. What do we have here? Two lovers, something that most people know something about. Again, two figures, one sculpture. They're inseparable as figures. There's a contrast between the elongation of the male figure and then the way the female figure is wrapped around his body. The emotional content is not for me to explain. It's for each person to get whatever they wish. But we can enjoy the abstract qualities of all these curves and movements and stillness. There's a stillness and a movement.